I have a prospect for this demo which will be deceptively simple, but in fact it is hard. I will show you a piece of code which you cannot complete by only relying on pure object-oriented design, because eventually that would lead to creation of a big ball of mud. So there exists a point, especially in large cloud applications, where you would need a more robust programming model, which I will call modern object-oriented programming. You will see what I mean by that. Let me show you the code. Here is an empty demo application. There will be a simple model representing a person containing some private encapsulated data. We value encapsulation in object-oriented design. We appreciate it for many good reasons. I will add one more model, equally simple. We will use this one in procurement. It models a request to make a purchase. Every request would be signed eventually. This is the method which puts a signature on the request. Ignore all validation and everything. That is not the topic of this demo. The topic is the design and one particular complication which we will experience when I add a new requirement. Besides the person who signed the request, there could be another person who would benefit from the purchase, a beneficiary. Do you see what I'm doing? Between the lines, I'm already on the verge of creating a big ball of mud, though there is little evidence to prove that this early into the project. The caller can either set a beneficiary explicitly or, if not, it will be the signee. That is a subtle logic coming from customers' requirements, which also say that there is a second method of signing a purchase request where a supreme person authorizes the purchase on behalf of someone else. Trouble in paradise. There are two ways to perform the same business operation. Who will decide? It's not the purchase request object, so much is obvious. That object will do what it is told. The logic must reside somewhere else. And so I am on the verge of creating a tangled knot which will, if left unattended, lead to creation of an infamous big ball of mud. Let me move this class to a separate file so we can focus on making that choice. I want to follow traditional object-oriented design here. That means you tell the object what you want to see done and it does it. Classes expose behavior via public methods. The trouble comes when there exist multiple possible implementations of the same method. That is where we choose to delegate the decision to the class system. Instead of deciding which execution branch to take, we expect to have a concrete implementation of an abstract class or an interface that does a straightforward job. There would be a manager, and managers, they ask no one, they sign things off. They proudly send themselves down the line, so sign of this. But regular employees, oh, they have different privileges, or the lack of. An employee has a manager, and the manager would need to approve any purchase. When the time comes to sign the request, you can imagine an employee asking the manager for permission. I will skip that logic, because my focus here is on the call it will make. Look here. This class will call a different method than the manager class above. That is how we branch in object-oriented code. We don't branch, we choose an object, and an object always does the work in a straightforward way. That is the massive benefit of object-oriented programming. And its single point of failure. This is how you fail. I have moved the classes to their permanent positions in the project tree. The employee is defined in the human resources part of the project. You can imagine this class being in this namespace since its inception. In a way, the employee would be born in human resources department. And so, when it comes to signing the request, it needs a dependency on the procurement namespace to complete it. That is not a crime yet. But now let's look on the other side of the fence, the procurement department just mentioned. Every purchase request managed by this part of the application keeps a hard dependency on human resources namespace. I made a circular dependency between namespaces. They will stay within the same assembly forever. Repeat this mistake 1,000 times in a large project, and you will have your big ball of mud long before ending. This mistake was only the first step in a series of mistakes where eventually everybody will reference everybody else. One might suspect that every object-oriented project is predestined to become a big ball of mud if it grows large enough. If class-based polymorphism were the only thing we had, then this would be our destiny, wouldn't it? So object-oriented programming adapted to the situation. In domain-driven design, we would introduce subdomains. Human resources would be the upstream subdomain, and procurement would be the downstream one. The downstream service receives the data and it must clean them up in an anti-corruption layer. I said service. I don't have services in this project yet. So this code is not service-oriented, but you can use another term, service-based. It looks like there are services inside this same project, this same process, when it executes. One day I might deploy them separately. Procurement namespace will depend on human resources namespace, but not the other way around. The sign method defined on classes in the human resources namespace will have no access to the sign method in procurements. This implementation will never compile. The path to understanding what I'm telling you here is to understand that this behavior never belonged to these classes anyway. The big ball of mud begins with misplaced responsibilities, remember that. The ball is in the other team's yard now, where it always belonged. But now I have lost all behavior that connects people with purchases. Nobody is calling these methods anymore. Will I admit foreign logic into this class and see it grow into 1,000 lines of code monster over the years? Here is a better way of dealing with these loosely related concerns today. Adopt functional mindset. It comes hand in hand with the process of untangling the data, which I have completed a minute ago. An extension method that applies to a type from this namespace and completes one business operation. Signing a purchase request has become an isolated behavior now. It is all there with a twist. Instead of creating a smaller ball of mud here, I have implemented the subdomain by mixing object-oriented and functional programming. Download the source code and read it. And watch this video next, it will come in handy after learning this technique of decoupling domains using extension methods and records.